Hello, welcome to the Where to Start reading series. Today we're covering Spider-Man. I'm your host, Brendon Strevig. You can check me out online here. This video is made for the Priestley Forsyth Memorial Library in Northumberland, Pennsylvania. You can stop in or check us out online. I make these Where to Start reading videos, and I break down the characters' origins so you know what they're about. And then I give you the reading order from start to finish with as little overlapping as possible. Now, I'm sure by now, with three different Spider-Men, we all know the origin of Spider-Man, but I'm still gonna do it just for those who might not, so here it is.
All right, people, let's do this one last time. My name is Peter B. Parker. I was bitten by a radioactive spider, and for the last 22 years, I thought I was the one and only Spider-Man.
What a day.
I'm pretty sure you know the rest. You see, I saved the city, fell in love, I got married, saved the city some more, maybe too much. My marriage got testy, made some dicey money choices, don't invest in a spider-themed restaurant. Then like 15 years passed, blah, 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 super burn, I broke my back, a drone flew into my face, I buried Aunt May, my wife and I split up. But I handled it like a champion. Because you know what? No matter how many times I get hit, I always get back up. And I got a lot of time to reflect and work on myself. Did you know that seahorses, that they mate for life? Could you imagine a seahorse seeing another seahorse and then making it work? She wanted kids and it scared me. I'm pretty sure I broke her heart. Flash forward, I'm in my apartment doing push-ups, doing ab crunches, getting strong. When this weird thing happened, and I gotta say, weird things happen to me a lot, but this was real weird.
And now that that's out of the way, I have one more thing to say before we get into anything else. My favorite Spider-Man is Andrew Garfield. I was about 2 years old when the first Tobey Maguire Spider-Man movie came out, so I kind of grew up with him, and he definitely made me a fan. But I was going into high school and just finishing up middle school when Andrew Garfield Spider-Man came around, and just his problems with girls and balancing life and all these other things. Was very relatable at the time, and he's just the Spider-Man I connect with the most. Now, I do love all Spider-Men, and I gotta say, Tom Holland is a really great actor with some really incredible moments and powerful scenes. But I grew up with the Spider-Man animated series as well, and I was used to a Spider-Man that was mostly self-sufficient and would have an occasional team-up here or there, but was mostly on his own. So Tom Holland Spider-Man just doesn't relate a lot. He's not the Spider-Man I grew up with, but he's still a good Spider-Man. And now we can get into my Spider-Man reading recommendations. Now, like I said, I'm a big fan of the movies, and I don't mind these comic book adaptations. I kind of like them. It's like watching the movie, but shorter. The movie might take me like 2 hours, and one of these might take me only like 45 minutes to an hour to read. That said, you can check out Spider-Man, the first movie adaptation, Spider-Man 2, Spider-Man 3, and The Amazing Spider-Man 1 and 2 both got prelude comics, and Spider-Man Homecoming and Far From Home also got prelude comics. Now, if you want a modern retelling of Spider-Man's origin, I recommend Spider-Man Season 1. And if you don't mind the writing in older comics, you can check out Amazing Spider-Man Epic Collection, Great Power. You can also check out The Amazing Spider-Man Masterworks Volume 4 and 5 for two iconic Spider-Man stories. After that, I recommend Spider-Man Death of the Stacys, which includes the death of Gwen Stacy and her father, Captain Stacy. Next, you can check out Spider-Man Origin of the Hobgoblin for no other reason than the Hobgoblin, Lizard, Carnage, and Mysterio are all among some of my favorite Spider-Man villains. Also, just a side note, if anyone remembers the Mysterio mission in the theater from the PlayStation 2 Spider-Man 2 game. And if you don't, go buy it and treat yourself. You're missing out. Now, back on track, you can check out Secret Wars, which includes the origin of Spider-Man's iconic black symbiote suit. And then you can check out Spider-Man, The Birth of Venom. After that, you can check out fan favorite Spider-Man, Kraven's Last Hunt, followed by Spider-Man, Sinister Six, just because it's got some of Spider-Man's best villains teaming up. Next, I recommend The Amazing Spider-Man Volume 1, Coming Home, which we actually have at the library, and I read on a really slow day and really enjoyed. So after that, you can check out The Amazing Spider-Man Volume 2, Revelations, which is the follow-up. After that, I recommend Peter Parker's Spider-Man, Return of the Green Goblin, which has one of my favorite comic book artists, Humberto Ramos, on it. After that, we get the Marvel event Civil War with the classic Iron Spider costume. So check out Civil War, which has some major side effects and consequences for Spider-Man. So also check out The Amazing Spider-Man Civil War and Peter Parker Spider-Man Civil War. Spider-Man then hit what some fans would call an all-time low, and his world was reset with an awful book a lot of people hate. So you want to skip ahead to Spider-Man Election Day, followed by Spider-Man American Son. After that, you can check out Spider-Man Died in Your Arms Tonight, and I only really say that just because I like the song Died in Your Arms Tonight. After that, you can check out Spider-Man New Ways to Live for some Black Cat action, and then The Avenging Spider-Man, My Friends Can Beat Up Your Friends, Avenging Spider-Man, The Good, The Green, and The Ugly, and Avenging Spider-Man, Threats and Menaces. Spider-Man then got another iconic suit, and one of my favorites, the Big Time suit. So check out Spider-Man Big Time, followed by Spider-Man The Return of Anti-Venom, and then Spider-Man Spider Island, and Spider-Man Ends of the Earth, only because of this iconic moment from the animated series years ago. So after that, you can check out Spider-Man Lizard, No Turning Back, which is really good, and then Spider-Man Danger Zone, which is also really good, Spider-Man Dying Wish, which is pretty good, and it's at this point, Peter Parker's dead, in quotation marks, and Doc Ock is in his body, and we get the Superior Spider-Man series, which was pretty solid, and I would definitely check it out if I were you. After the series, we eventually got Peter Parker back in his own body, so you can then check out the new Amazing Spider-Man 2014 run. I myself really enjoyed this run, and it also includes Spider-Verse. After that comes The Amazing Spider-Man Worldwide, which I thought had the premise to be really good, but it really sucks. So I tried Volume 2, it was a little bit better, Volume 3 is a little worse, and I have Volume 4 sitting on my pile to read stuff, but way at the bottom. After that, you can check out Spider-Geddon, which I've heard really good things about. Now, I also highly recommend the Ultimate Universe Spider-Man, so you can check out Ultimate Spider-Man from 2000. There is 22 collected issues, and I read these as an early teen and thought they were great. And I don't remember why, but I kind of just stopped reading after Volume 12, Carnage. But you can also check out Ultimate Spider-Man, Death of Spider-Man, which is really good. And that's actually all I have for you.
That's all, folks.
So I hope now you can use the knowledge I gave you to go find a Spider-Man story you really love. Once again, this video is made for the Priestley Forsyth Memorial Library. Check us out online or stop in. I'm your host, Brendon Strevig. Check me out online here. See you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.